August of my sophomore year, I was getting really convicted about who I was, what I was doing, just everything in general. And then I got a really convicting vision, and I set my life straight. I started going to the college Christian ministries, which it didn't take me that long. Well, actually, I knew before that they were mostly social dating clubs. You know, so as I went, I got more on fire for God personally from my prayer, my personal prayer work and different things like that. I saw the culture, so I started getting more focused on my church. And they had a evangelism program, went out with that, but it was mostly like house visits where we'd meet like older people, you know, talk to them about Jesus Christ. It was really kind of, it wasn't, but I, throughout the entire thing, I kept on getting hit with Romans 1:16. Unashamed. And I thought that the one-on-one witnessing was great. I thought passing out tracts was great. But then I started hearing, you need to preach. That's where the money is. That's where all the eternal rewards were. Like, I just had it in my, I could not think of anything else. I was like, I need to start yelling at random strangers about my religious dogma.
Amen, brother.
And, you know, I was like, this really means a lot to me, but I was like, God, I need an example. I don't have anybody right now. And my pastor, he said that he went to England and preached a little bit and got called some names, and you know, about it. But I was like, okay, well, that's my only example. I didn't really know about anything else. So I started, in December, I started praying. I started praying for boldness. Praying, and by February, and then I also prayed for another thing, to become a man of integrity, which, you know, with my doctrine, I didn't really believe could happen. So it was kind of like a miracle if it could. So I started praying that, and then Brother Jed came to my campus.
Jed, go!
Oh, hallelujah!
And I thought, the week and a half that he was there, I thought of everything that the sinners thought, I was thinking that.
Wow.
And I did not want to get rebuked. So what I did was, see, the thing is with the rebuke, if you want to get rebuked, you hang around in the first two rows. That's typically where the preachers get them and different things like that. So I hang out in the back with other people, okay, not to make myself a target, except Wednesday, you know, I kind of got too comfortable. And I sat in the second row, and there wasn't anyone around me. And then Sister Pat comes up and she's like, are you a Christian? I said, yes, of course.
Amen.
Are you a virgin? Yes, of course.
Thank you. Yay.
Are you sin-free? And I didn't think by my doctrine, I thought by how pure my heart was. I really searched my heart and I was like, no, I'm clean. Like, I got right, you know, in August, and you know, I've been living, but I didn't think, but it really struck me, like, wow, that was, and it felt like something off my chest that I was, you know, so I did agree with that, but I saw Brother Jed and just the power behind it and different things like that, and by the end of the week, Brother Jed said, who will rise up for God? I may not come back next year. I could die, you know, and it's been great, so. And I said, I stood up, and I said, I will. And that Monday, I started.
Amen.
Glory.
Praise the Lord.
Jed fruit.
That's all I had.
Amen.
Amen. That's enough.
That topic.
Amen.
Thank you, Brad.
All right. Are you still a virgin?
Of course.
Wow.
Hey, don't get so personal. Sit down. It's your turn's over.
When you get to the park, how old are you?
Yeah, 24.
And a virgin. Wow.
Yeah.
Go team.
God. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Excited to be here. Cursed from birth. And my dad was a street preacher. Amen. Preached with Holy Hubert for 30 years. And so I...
What's his name?
He'll be here in a minute. And so the first time I ever preached was in front of an XX video store with my dad. And I just knew at that point in my life, this is what I'm supposed to do for the rest of my life.
Wow.
And And then ever since then, I went to Bible college, which was an absolute waste of time. I never encourage anybody to go to Bible college. And I went to Bible college and figured out just exactly that I didn't want to be like anybody there. And still, till this day, nobody at from my Bible college has anything to do with me.
Wow.
Amen. So, praise God. So, I've been preaching almost 18 years now. Really excited to be down here for Vegas. And, knowing more than anything that to really preach God's word unadulterated to wicked people, that you really have to be compelled. When you go buy a strip joint, or when you go buy an XX video store, when you go buy something that's just absolutely deplorable and wicked, you know that this is something you're supposed to do. Yeah. Something just rises up in you. I have to be kind of low profile because I'm a high-end designer in my town, and I have a big, huge, you know, a store and so forth or whatever. So I have to be real methodical about what I do. But the Lord's brought me a couple really great disciples, and they always want to go out.
Yeah.
So it's just like, okay. And so like my good brother Peter here, you know, we're driving along, and hey man, what is that? I was like, man, I preached to that 10 years ago, man. What do you mean, what is that? You know, so I praise God for that. I praise God that no matter what, the endurance and the strength and being compelled to still want to do something for the kingdom of God is still there. And I still have a strong relationship with Jesus Christ. And we drove, we got in this morning at 4:30. And we are ready to absolutely just smash the living daylights out of this city.
Amen.
So that's why we're here. God bless.
Oh.
Yeah. Is his dad gonna have an opportunity to give a testimony?
Yeah.
When?
We'll have it. We'll have more testimonies today and then
right.
Tomorrow.
Okay.
So you'll hear a lot about him.
Amen.
Okay. It is interesting. We all have different testimonies of how the Lord moved us. Some of us compelled by reading the Bible, maybe a YouTube clip, and so that's Christianity. And so, if you want us to have the same testimony, we'd be Mormons. They all have the same testimony, but we're not. And so, God might compel you a different way. And so, mine was very simple. I read the Bible, and after I got saved, I started talking about Jesus. And then the first time I ever preached was in front of the church I grew up in. And so I raised my Bible and I preached to people going in. My mom was inside the church.
Wow.
And so, you know, the altar boy came out and said, does Father know that you're out here, Reuben? And I said, yeah, God, Father knows I'm here. Absolutely. And so I was 18 years old, 1980, and nothing's changed since then.
Wow.
I've still kept the same course. And so God will inspire you in a lot of different ways. You'll be surprised when you hear these testimonies. So they are